Valvular heart disease is a condition in which the heart valves of the patient are affected by a disease process that results in either the valve not being able to open adequately or not being able to close adequately. This will result in several situations called either stenosis of the valve or regurgitation of the valve. So stenosis of the valve refers to a condition where the valve is become narrow and is obstructing the blood flow. A regurgitation is a condition where the valve starts leaking and thereby causing dysfunction of the valve. Mitral valve is an important valve which is located on the left side of the heart, which guards the connection between the left atrium, the upper chamber, and the left ventricle, the lower chamber. So when the valve gets affected by a disease process, it is called mitral valve disease. So many patients who have this disease of the mitral valve, either because it's becoming excessively narrow or because of it becoming causing excessive leakage of back leakage of blood, then a situation comes when the valve will have to be replaced. So mitral valve replacement is a commonly performed surgery for patients who have mitral valve disease. So there are two types of valves. One is the metallic valve, where a metallic artificial mitral valve is implanted. This is obviously done by means of open heart surgery, and a metallic valve is positioned in the position of the original mitral valve after removing the diseased portions of the mitral valve. Another type of valve, which is again implanted in the same method by open heart surgery, is a tissue valve or a bioprosthetic valve. So there are some situations where the tissue valve is preferred over the metallic valve. Usually in younger patients in whom the life expectancy is very long, a metallic valve is preferred because metallic valves are more durable and are more long-lasting. Whereas in some situations, we prefer tissue valves. The reason why we prefer tissue valves in some patients is because in patients who have a metal mitral valve, they need to take a blood thinner medication lifelong. So these blood thinner medications have some problems. They need to be monitored every month with a blood test. And then the values of the blood tests keep fluctuating up and down erratically, and the effect of the medicine is influenced by several factors, including several items of food that the patient may consume in his diet. So there's some challenges in using this blood thinner medication in patients who have a replaced metal heart valve. To overcome this problem, especially in older people, in people who are 65 years or older, when a mitral valve needs to be replaced, it is customary to replace with what we call a tissue valve. A tissue valve is usually derived from the outer covering of the heart called the pericardium of an animal. It's either a buffalo or it's a pig. So from the outer covering of the heart of one of these animals, the artificial tissue valve is prepared, and that is sewn surgically by means of open heart surgery. So these tissue valves are attractive because they behave more or like the normal heart valve. And yet, because they are tissue valves, there's no requirement to take lifelong blood thinner medication. Usually after 3 months, the blood thinner medication can be stopped. So that is the biggest advantage of a tissue valve. However, one problem with tissue valves is that over a period of time, after 10 to 15 years, these valves start deteriorating in their quality. This is called degeneration of a tissue prosthetic valve. So when this kind of degeneration occurs, again, the valve starts functioning abnormally. Either it can become narrow or there can be some leakage in the valve. When either of these things happens, when there is dysfunction or damage to an already implanted tissue heart valve. Then comes the question is, what do we do to the patient? Initially, we can manage these patients with medication. But over a period of time, the time comes when we need to replace these valves. So how do we replace these valves? So all along, traditionally, what we have been doing is subjecting the patient to a second open heart surgery. And open heart surgery and put another tissue valve after removing this valve. So however, in these patients who may be now 75 years or older than 75 years, second open heart surgery definitely puts them at a higher risk of having complications. So we had a similar patient recently who had a tissue heart valve implanted upon him surgically through means of an open heart surgery about 15 years ago, and the valve got damaged or degenerated. So he needed a replacement of the valve. So how do we do it? He was 75 years old and he was at a high risk for going for a second open heart surgery. So we did a novel procedure on this patient. We implanted a percutaneous procedure, that is without cutting open the chest, through the artery of the leg, we implanted a transcatheter heart valve. It's a catheter which has a heart valve which we have introduced through the artery in the groin, and by means of without surgery under local anesthesia, we have gone ahead and implanted this valve in the same place where the previous valve was existing. So this is a valve in valve implantation. So implantation of a new tissue heart valve within an old and damaged tissue heart valve by means of a transcatheter procedure without involving open heart surgery. This is called transcatheter mitral valve implantation by a valve in valve method. So this procedure was done in about an hour and the patient went home in 2 or 3 days. The patient in fact was walking the very next morning. So this greatly improved the symptoms of the patient and the patient is doing extremely well. So we are happy that we could help this patient through this novel procedure of transcatheter mitral valve implantation in a pre-existing damaged or degenerated tissue heart valve. So this procedure helped the patient undergo a valve replacement with minimal risk and with the utmost benefit that this patient had. So we are happy to be of help in this patient.